My name is Eddie McGoldrick, and I'm the founder of Power On Technologies Ltd, and we are a member of the Domestic Electrical Energy Storage System Collaborative Network, which is a long phrase for smart batteries. A facilitator is the key thing that this has brought into it. The facilitator can't make a poor network good, but they can make a good network excellent. And that's what we found with the facilitator. It brought something new that we didn't have and was also useful in later stages. When we looked at the scoping study, we thought, oh, this is small stage before we get to the good stuff. But in reality, the scoping study was very good for clarifying our thinking. We actually have changed our approach in some ways, and also what it did was it brought other people's ideas into it. Particularly in a small startup, sometimes you're trying to do everything and think you have to solve everything. But the scoping study widened the group and widened the expertise that we had. When you work in a collaborative network, the key word for me is network. That brings much more into the equation. As a small startup, we don't have all the skills and expertise. If we did have all the skills and expertise, we would need to be enormous. And size slows you down sometimes. So the fact that you have a network and all of those people are able to move and change is very, very, very powerful. Collaboration is a challenge for us because we're small and some people are a bit larger, but the facilitation, the fact of the network and the rules around it actually help, because that sets a framework within which you can operate. Well, what we're doing differently is actually we're working across companies. We've been trying to do everything on our own. So fundamentally, it has put us into a position where we work with and depend on and get contribution from a wider group of people. It has also allowed us to look at markets, new markets, sooner than we had anticipated we could do that, but we'll need some more thought and scoping to do that, and that's something that we're working on. As a group, you get a strength that one individual company doesn't have, and you have a credibility as a group. Key issue for us has been stakeholders. So the credibility of the group has allowed us to engage with stakeholders on a much more credible basis. We're speaking as the collective. It's not just one individual company with one opinion. So I think that has been very, very significant for us and has allowed us to, if you like, punch above our weight.
Hello, I'm Anne-Marie McGoldrick. I am Director of Power On Technologies Ltd. We have a collaborative network with Invest and I, and it's called the Domestic Electric Energy Storage. And basically, it's a device for storing energy in your home. Through the collaborative network, it's given us access to people we wouldn't have access to before. It's allowed us to make a better go at the opportunity we perceived at the start. It's allowed us to have challenges put to us that has tested us and allowed us to be more credible in the opportunity we put forward with our company. I think we've always been really strong believing and passionate about our company. However, the challenges that come with trying to manage a supply chain, trying to manage a group of individuals who all have their own personal and credible input into what has become a really strong project, that's been a challenge for us. So having to listen to other people and having to include them in what we put forward as our great idea and our great innovation has been a challenge for us, but has really taught us to listen to other people and put them first and listen to what they've got to say. The The actual scope and study document has been really useful for us. It's given us a document that we can go and talk to people that we couldn't have done that before. People within the department, for instance, we've been able to go to them, walk them through what's in the scoping study. And as a result of that, we've had full support from them, and they're now part of our stakeholder group, which is excellent for us. It's allowed us to go and look further afield and start talking about exports with a credibility that we couldn't have done before. So I think for us, our next stage now is, once we've established it in Northern Ireland, we are intending to go to the Republic of Ireland and hopefully further afield.
Okay.